إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أما بعد فيقول الحق سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون، يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما، أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. ثم أما بعد، my beloved brothers and sisters, as we always, we welcome all the brothers to be together, gathering in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the best day of the week, the day of Yawm al-Jum'ah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ta'a and ibadah and du'a, our ruku' and sujood. And after saying that, we come to the topic of today, and this topic, it will conclude everything that the Muslim needs in daily life. And our topic today is going to be about the time is life. الوقت هو الحياة. Our time, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He it is, the one who created and established the day and night in a succession way, so the Muslim can remember and get recognized that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who created, who made the day and night, so we can live, we can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In many ayat in Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He swear by the time. He swear by the night. قال سبحانه وتعالى والليل إذا يغشى. He swear by the times. قال تعالى والعصر. He swear by the time. قال تعالى والفجر وليالي العشر. Allah سبحانه وتعالى, in the Quran, if He swear by anything, it means it's great. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, which is narrated by Abi Barzata al-Aslami, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تزول قدم عبد حتى يسأل عن أرض. Four things you will not leave from the hisab of Yawm al-Qiyamah until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you about four things. One, عن عمره فيما أفناه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is going to ask you about the time of this dunya, the time of your age, the time of your life. How did you spend your day?
How did you spend your night? Is it in ta'a, in ibadah? Do you really practice and apply the shara of this deen on your time? عن عمره فيما أفناه وعن باسمه فيما أبلاه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not the human, not the mankind, Al-Khaliq subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will ask you about the body, your jism, your jasad. What did you use it for? Did you use it in ta'a? Did you use it in ibadah? Did you bow down and make rukur and sujood and use it and make your body tired in ta'a, in salah, in dhikr, in hajj, in umrah, in fasting? Or you use it for the muharramat? وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه. The healthy time, the youth time you had, what did you use it? Youth was 40, 50 and up. What did you do when he was 20, 25, 30? What did you do that time? Was really a Muslim that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with? The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَعَنْ مَالِ مِنْ أَيْنَ اكْتَسَبَ وَفِيمَ أَنْفَقَ. The income you collected every day and every night. Ya Abdullah, the income, the man, you have it in your hand and you collect it from everywhere. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will ask you, he will ask the Muslim, he will ask everyone, where did you collect that money from? Where you collect that food from? Where you have your clothes from? Where you have your house from? Whatever you left or you feed your family from, where you get it from? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will ask you about all of these questions. As you're listening right now, isn't it the answer ready? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, min shadim hadith, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man ahabba liqa Allah, ahabba Allah liqa. Whoever loves it to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will love to meet. وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهُ كَرِهَ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَ. And whoever hates to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will hate to meet him. عائشة رضي الله عنها asked رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله, isn't it all of us hate the death? Everyone hate that moment, the death. The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, Ya Aisha, not everyone. Not everyone. The Muslims who's involved in ta'a and ibadah, he knows that he's gonna meet a life different from this life. Dar al-Baqa, Dar al-Khulud, the Jannah, al-Firdaus al-A'la. That's why he's gonna love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the one who involved not in dunya, in the hawa, in his own life, not in ta'a, not in ibadah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, that's the one who's gonna hate to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he knows his akhirah, it will be hard. And Luqman used to tell his son, oh my son, since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought you to this life, every day it comes, you are closer to the akhirah than the dunya. You see the hikmah? the knowledge, the ilm, the wise. He's telling his son, every day you face him, you are closer to the akhirah than your dunya. Did you think about that? Today, you are close to the akhirah than the dunya we had. Tomorrow, you're going to be closer and closer. Al-Hasan al-Basri used to say that every morning, every day, munadin yunadi, fayaqul, ana yawmun jadid, wa ala amalika shahid, faghtanimni, fa inni la'a'ud ila yawmun. Al-Hasan al-Basri used to say that the day call everyone, say, I am a new day with you, and I will be a witness in your amal. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم وأيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون. يومئذ يوفيهم الله دينهم الحق ويعلمون أن الله هو الحق المبين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, is not يوم القيامة as you have. The time right now is gonna pass like that. يوم القيامة, day of judgment, is gonna be like this year. It will go day by day, so easy, so smooth. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who will make the haqq, the truth to take place on that day. So he says, everything is gonna take another case. يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم, the tongue that he uses, isn't it for halal, for the ta'ah, for reciting the Quran, for dhikr, for the ruku', for du'a, for sujood, oh, for the muharramah, for the bad biting. And you know, one Muslim brother told me other day, you know, the Muslim nowadays, the lie, the bad biting, became so easy. Bad biting became so easy. Why? What's gonna benefit you? Speaking the Muharramat became so easy. What's gonna benefit you? Wallahi, nothing except is gonna come in your book in Yawm al-Qiyamah. يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم أيديهم, and your hands also, your feet also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he finished and he ended this ayah by saying, بما كانوا يعملون. Any عمل, any deed you have it done today, yesterday, or the tomorrow is gonna come as next. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gonna take everything you talk about this amal, the tongue, the hand, the legs. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَوْمَئِذٍ, on that day, the time you have today, يُوَفِّيهُمُ اللَّهُ دِينَهُمُ الْحَقِّ. Then the haqq, you left, you neglect, you're gonna face it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ الْمُبِينَ. On that day, everything you skipped, everything you left, you will face it on Yawm al-Qiyamah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. فاستغفر الله. أن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. وبعد، عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه used to say كل في الدنيا كأنك غريب أو عابر سبيل. عمر الفاروق دي خليفة as gonna mention about عمر learn he should say كن في الدنيا be in this life this time كأنك غريب as a stranger or عابر سبيل passerby. Then also he used to say إذا أمسيت فلا تنتظر الصباح. If you reach morning evening, if you reach the evening, I would like to ask the brother, as you see rain outside, and the brother used to sit down outside, they have more rooms, but as so far there are no rooms outside, I would like to ask the brother, inshallah, move up please, and have more rooms for the brother to have their salah. Please, inshallah, those block in that way. Those block in that way, the brothers. If you stand in there or sit in there, our brothers can pass and come. So, Umar said, إذا أمسيت فلا تنتظر الصباح. If you reach the evening, do not wait for the morning. Do you think that way? وإذا أصبحت فلا تنتظر المساء. If you reach morning, do not wait for the evening. And you need to also remind by the ayat of the Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, ذرهم يأكلوا ويتمتعوا ويلههم الأمل فسوف يعلمون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Quran, let everyone eat, enjoying this life, ويلههم الأمل, and be busy with this dunya, with this life. Forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. A time is gonna come, you will know what did you forget about. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speak about the time, the waqt, the life, the hayat in certain ayat of Surah Al-Mu'minun. قال سبحانه وتعالى أفحسبتم أنما خلقناكم عبثا. Isn't it? You believe or you think the time you have today is عبث, has nothing, has no purpose, and وأنكم إلينا لا ترجعون, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى He will not brought you back. أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ فتعالى الله الملك الحق. الله سبحانه وتعالى His حق, His ملك, His the one who owns everything, as Allah سبحانه وتعالى who in the يوم القيامة will take place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will call لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will call, He will ask today, before in dunya, everyone used to say, I own this, this is mine, I own that, this belongs to me. but يوم القيامة. Nothing belong anyone. Allah سبحانه وتعالى He will ask لمن الملك اليوم. No one will be able to say anything. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will say, He will answer on Himself. He will say, لله الواحد القهار. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the time, about the waqt, those who didn't use the shar' of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya, قال سبحانه وتعالى وقالوا قالوا they're gonna say وقالوا لو كنا نسمع أو نعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير. The one who lost, I don't want to say the kafir, the disbelievers, the munafiqs, even the Muslim. The ayat of Surah Al-Mulk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ. Imagine, nowadays, when anything takes place, then you blame yourself. Then you're gonna say, why I did this? I'm not supposed to do it. I'm supposed to do something else. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, behalf of us, وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ. If we listen today, أَوْ نَعْقِلْ. And if we use our intelligence, if we use our intelligence, we will not be in the fire. Will not be in the punishment. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاعْتَرَفُوا بِذَنْبِهِمْ. You will say, I did everything in dunya, يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. Really? Yes. Isn't I said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَوْمَ تَشْهَدُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Who's gonna be witness on you? أَلْسِنَتُهُ. Your tongue. Your hands and your legs, they're gonna come as a witness. So, do you really reflect, think about that time? Or you just let it go? Abdullah ibn Abbas used to say, اعرف قلبك في ثلاث مواطن. Know how you are, your character, your own self, your heart, in three times. One of them, في خلوتك. When you are alone, no one see you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters, time is life. Time is gonna pass. Time is gonna go. But no one will hold this time except who uses it in ta'ah and ibadah. Last point of today, I will say, كيفية إطالة العمر. It means how you can live longer. Isn't it true? Can we live longer? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said for someone he's gonna live 50. Is there any way to live 55? I don't mean that. The Muslims, the Sahaba, the one of ilm, they do not calculating the years by numbers. No, by how much you did. How much you did. I will give example with a few of the Sahaba. Abi Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. His khilafah 2.5 years. 2.5 years.
How much he did?
قضى على حروب الردة. He stopped the ردة in Islam. And ردة means who left the fold of the Islam to the kufr. He sent أسامة بن زيد with the Muslim army to fight the kuffar. 2.5 years. And he know رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم what he told أبا بكر one day was a talk going on between رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and أبا بكر. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he told him يا أبا بكر, and this رواية البخاري, do you know people who saw they gonna enter the Jannah from the door of Siyar. People of Zakah, they're gonna enter the Jannah from the people of Zakah. People of Salah, they're gonna enter the Jannah from the door of Salah. Abi Bakr, with this ta'a, an iman, an intelligence he had, he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is there anyone will enter from these doors? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said يا أبا بكر, yes is you will enter from these doors. All of them أبو بكر will enter from it. Do you think about that? The Muslim nowadays put the علم of this deen the last step. Last step. If today you ask the Muslim recite Surah Al-Fatiha in a correct way, I will say إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. You recite Surah Al-Fatiha in correct way. Recite Surah Al-Fatiha exactly how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send Jibreel with to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How we nowadays? I don't want to say memorize the whole Quran, memorize the whole Sunnah, be Ali, be no. I just said only Surah Al-Fatiha. Find yourself from that step. The Muslims left the ilm. What others gonna benefit you? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Another example. For the time, Umar ibn al-Khattab, al-Faruq, Umar, and how much he gave the Islam. And you know, see how the taqwa and khawf, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of these people. Once, Umar was running after a camel, single camel, where is the Khalifa, to catch it. And this camel was from the مال الصدقة. مال الصدقة. And in that moment, Uthman ibn Affan, he saw a man running. Then he left his house and he started to see him who's running. Then he saw his Umar. Then he told him, Ya Umar, just sit. You are Amir al-Mu'mineen. And just let any of the workers go and pick it up. But Umar said, yes, I am Amir al-Mu'mineen. I'm the leader of the Muslim states. He said to Uthman a word. And this word is going to be a flag for every Muslim to think about it. Ya Uthman, this is مال الصدقة. أتحمل عني أوزاري يوم القيامة? Isn't it? You're gonna come يوم القيامة and carry my sins? Just because of single camel running and he ran after it to catch it. What about many things running out from our life, doesn't mean it has to be camel. Many hours goes in nonsense. Umar ibn Abdul Hadid, how much he did for the Islam. The Khilafah of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, it is similar to Abu Bakr, 2.5 years. Do you know how much he did for the Islam in 2.5 years? Bayti mal battay, he made it only because of taqwa, of al-amal al-salih, of the iman he had. Too many things took place. When the mal of Bayti mal was a lot, because whoever has any loan, Bayti mal will pay this loan. And after everyone paid off whatever loan they have, money is still there. He said, whoever didn't marry yet, Bayti mal will help to let them everyone marry. Everyone got married. Then money is still there. It's the barakah of the amal, the barakah of the ta'a, made everything increased. Last one, you will be surprised. Whoever didn't go for the Hajj, Bayt al-Mal will pay off the expenses of the Hajj to Bayt Allah al-Haram. This is the Muslim. So, time is not by how long you live, it's how much you give, not how long you live. I will end the khutbah by two things is gonna take place this month and the new year. Example, the 25th and the new year, as the non-Muslim celebrate that. We call it Christmas. The old ulama, I had a big collection just to see, but I want to prove it. This is not from the Islam. And as you're celebrating this with the Nasara, it's exactly you celebrating when they said, Isa is the son of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can you say that? Isa is the son of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you believe it? This is kufr. So make sure whoever sitting right now listening to the khutbah, whoever sitting right now listening to the reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be aware from any haram, be aware from anything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with. Christmas, these things is not from the Islam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عندما قدم المدينة, when he entered the Medina, he saw the people there, they're celebrating. Thing is not from the Islam, it's from the Jahiliyyah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, leave all of this, and you're gonna have two things, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. So brothers and sisters, anything not from the Islam, stay away from Christmas, New Year, December 25th. The thing is, it's not from the Islam, it's from the Muharramat. Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn al-Qayyim, the ulama of this time, the ulama of the Sahaba, all of them goes against it. It is Muharramat. Be aware. Teach your family. كلكم راعي كلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. Make sure. Learn the right and true Islam. And I will end the khutbah by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا، اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت على الحق أقدامنا، وثبت على الحق أقدامنا. اللهم انصرنا على القوم الكافرين، وأعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اشف أمراضنا، اللهم اشف أمراضنا، اللهم ارحم أمواتنا، اللهم ارحم أمواتنا. اللهم بارك لنا في بيوتنا وأرزاقنا وأولادنا وأزواجنا، واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا لكل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا لكل شر. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم ولكم تستغفرون. أقول الله أكبر.